By way of introduction to the FMO theory, let me say that it's a perturbation theory. That's a term that has specific meaning in quantum mechanics, and we're not going to worry about those details. Instead, qualitatively, we can understand what's meant by the idea of perturbation theory if we look at this reaction coordinate diagram. For a molecule that has two possible reaction pathways that it could follow, what we're especially interested in is the transition state structures and especially the energy of those transition states. The pathway that has the lower barrier, the lower energy transition state, is going to be the reaction that goes the fastest, and under kinetic control, we would predict that product B is going to be formed more favorably than product A. Unfortunately, FMO theory doesn't apply to the region around the transition states. Instead, it's a theory that assumes we know a lot about the reactants, we know about the molecular orbitals and the molecular orbital energies of the reactants, and that we can then add small increments of change or a perturbation to those molecular orbital energies and molecular orbitals, and by that way we can predict the change in energy as a function of the change in the reaction coordinate. In other words, we can get information about the initial slope of the reaction pathway. For reactions that are exothermic, most of the reactions that we care about, we can then anticipate that the pathway that has the smaller slope is going to have the lower transition state energy and will be the faster reaction pathway. And so here, at the very early stages of this reaction, we see that the slope for the reaction pathway B is smaller than the slope for the reaction pathway A, and we would anticipate that B is favored over A. This idea of exothermicity as being where the FMO theory is going to be most applicable is related to Hammond's postulate, which basically says that the energies of the transition states are going to resemble the energy of the species that it's most closely to. In this case, for exothermic reactions, that's going to be the reactants. For his work that introduced us to the FMO theory to explain chemical reactivity, Fukui, along with Roel Hoffman, who also introduced a molecular orbital theory to explain chemical reactivity, shared the 1981 Nobel Prize in Chemistry. If you'd like to know more about the FMO model, I'd encourage you to take a look at this excellent book by Ian Fleming called Frontier Orbitals and Organic Chemical Reactions. In the next webcast, we'll begin to take a closer look at the FMO model, eventually putting it to use to explain differential reactivity of organic transformations.